Let's look closer on our layers panel. And we did work with this degrading some in other tutorials a little bit, but we'll look a little bit more closer on what layers we have it and how we can work with them. Overall, as we begin, you can see we have our background where we can set default and layers. You can change name if you need it by double time click. And we can type in name you want it, and this is will change. Also, for each layer above, we have a different blending mode. And if you work with Photoshop or Affinity or other ones, image manipulation applications, you're probably familiar with some of this, but overall, this is normal. Darken, it's usually have it from, if you have it white color, it will have it absolutely white, it will have it no effect soever, and the darker you're getting to the black, it's have it more effect. Lighten will opposite, if you have it a black color, it will have it no effect, it will be transparent, and as we're going lighter, it will have it more effect. Of course, some of this, like burns, they will have it more saturation, more contrast curving in. Next, we have it our contrast curves, overlay, soft lights, hard light. We like usually those ones, it will set on 50% gray, it's invisible, and it's going whiter or black will affect more. So those is a contrast based. And also we have it appliance kind of matte difference, exclusion, subtractions based on the colors, and based on the channels where we have huge saturation, color, and luminosity. And those is straight on. How I said before, if you work with the Photoshop, they're very straightforward, similar like you have there. So kind of familiar with these modes. And in many cases, you maybe use it, most likely you will use it or multiply, screen, soft light, and overlay. This is most time what was common for using this, and of course normal as a default. In some cases you maybe will use it color and luminosity, but again this is more rare. Mostly it will be normal, multiply, screen, overlay, soft light. And also below we have our opacity, which you can set from 0 to 100, and it specify for each individual layer. Also notice right here we have our layers that we can lock from editing, and it's with come up very helpful, so you accidentally don't draw on a specific layer when you're done with this. And as well we have a lock transparency if you have it any applied to this as well. So in this case with lock transparency you can still have paint over areas that is not transparent. Okay, right on the side we have it our selections. If we have it selected elements and how we did before, you can hide or show specific selections. Below we have our normal settings where we can clear all layers, so it is instead deleted. As example, we can draw something and we can just very fast clear the layers, remove everything, or you can also just select and delete it. Remember, Control Z, Command Z, undo will work as well on the layer, so you can go back as well. Next, we have it export to Photoshop. So you can click and export specific one. We can add layers and we can add vector layers. As well, we can go and duplicate layers currently selected. As well, we can go and merge layers together. Again, it's similar to Control E if you have multiple layers. And of course, remove the layers. The one I want to point, it is creating layer and add vector layer. So right here, this is normal vector. And if, for example, I'm going to draw something and I draw some path. Next, if I want to modify this path, I cannot do this at the point because it kind of already rendered and locked for me. So notice right here, we even have it our option to edit vector layers and we cannot do this. If you want to do a modify or you think in the future you want to adjust, you can always create a vector layer. And a vector layer will indicate by this squiggly line by eye icon. So let's see what's happened now. So when I draw, it's look, it's working similar to what was before. Okay, right here we can see before. But at this point, I have my option enabled to edit vector layer. And if I click on this, I have my edit path, and certainly I have my path display for me. At this moment, I can group. I can edit each position points if I want it. So I can reposition as I want them. Notice this, as I'm moving, it is adjusting in a lifetime preview for me. So I can modify lines. Also, when you do in edit vector mode, all of these brush creators or all options will also apply in a lifetime. So we can actually modify effect and you can see live preview on them as we're going. Example, if I wanted add even additional, so I can go right here, select and maybe add a different, and you can see it start adding all different effect. So we can go right there. In this case, you can modify your brush and you will see preview. In many cases, when you create your new brush, you work on this, I will recommend for you, if you work first on a shape, not necessarily flow of your brush, you can always just draw on the layer, vector layer, next going inside modify properties so you can see how it's work. And when you're satisfied with this, next work step probably will go and work more with the flow effect, how the when you move your mouse, how the brush flow, how it's created. But in this case, we'll create a vector. The one with draw with vector, you cannot draw another one on top. So for example, if I'm going select and I want draw secondary, it's come up warning, it says only a single stroke can be painted a vector layer. So you have it limitation. If you click OK, it will erase your previous and you can draw new. So you have some limitation, only one stroke is allowed. However, you always can create a new layer and do same on a new vector layer. So in this case, we have two vector layers and we can modify each of them individual. This is, will be one layer and this is second. Okay, let's see what's happening. If I have two vector layers, I select them and I'm going to merge them. As I merge, they convert from the vector to normal layer because this was two different strokes. So when we're done with this, now I cannot edit them and they kind of merge together to one raster type layer. So keep this in mind if you want to group them. If you're done and don't want to edit them anymore, you can merge them together as a vector. But if you think you were still modified, you want to keep them separated and not merged. By default, we can create a different color background, gradient, or anything. But in many cases, when I work, and if it's work not as plugin in Photoshop, I want to import my image so I can draw on this or modify. To do this, we can go in File, and we can go ahead and click on Import. And as Import, we can select Image by supported formats, and we import. Notice it is Import as New Layer. We can customize and adjust this layer by dragging in order. Let's disable our background right here. And also by default, it will try to scale to fit our base space. You have the ability to change. When you're done, press Enter, and this way it will create this layer. Notice if I change my order this time, background will overlay, so it will go above my image. Let's go put it up, and we'll take this layer and put it above. So this way, many times when you draw, it is a nicer way to use. For example, if I'm going to, okay, let's remove those layers, okay? I can go create a new layer, select the flame. Let's open our libraries. In the libraries, we'll go to select fire example. Okay, let's reduce a little bit on a size. And I can draw now or paint as I want it. And nice things about this, this is almost can be traceable. You can create different things. Okay, let's go right here. A little bit off. And sometimes you maybe want to do vector effect, but overall, if you're done, you can see you can easily create butterfly outline, not necessarily in this, but it is give you example of techniques how you can apply it. And I have some tutorials where we will use to create the jumping warriors with the flames and other things. And after this, kind of based on the tutorial, so you can do all this effect. But one nice thing about import, it can use as background. And as well, for example, in other ones, you can import landscape, and we can use it also just ideas, different effects. So let's go create new layer. And we'll go just create fuzzy. And right here in fuzzy, we'll go select clouds. And just imagine that you can add this nice smoke. Because I do a lot of compositing, for me, always use the same brushes to create fog. It's kind of sometimes they look alike, but this way I can create very unique clouds, smog, fog, and it's each of them will be different. So they, because they created the render fractal, so independently. And like how I said before, of course, you can switch all the blending mode. We can go to soft light or any other one, so it will look more like in a smoke or a mist we have at our butterfly. We'll get a little bit more working with the layers as we're going to work on our project, but here is kind of overview of this layers panel.